Hey, dear Capricorn, let's take a beautiful deep breath in, raising our vibration. Well, right off the top, I heard you don't need that. Release it. It is not helping you grow. And it's causing the battles. You don't need it. It's unhealthy. But you keep going back to it. Feel like it's a habit. We're going to ask Spirit to show you what blocks are in your love life. And definitely just know that there are solutions there to helping you release it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I feel like it's not only a habit, but it's a belief. And it's just embedded in who you are. But you absolutely can change that. For sure. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And I'm going to ask, for further clarity, but Spirit was already on it, blessing us as always. All right. So I feel like the energy that's coming in, dear Capricorn, is certainly from your past. And I feel like it's childhood. I see a little infant baby. And I feel like some of you just are not happy in love the way you could be. The way you could be just because you've left a relationship, maybe got divorced. But there's also abandonment issues. And Spirit's telling you, you know, honor your wisdom because that wisdom came in from the experiences, the knowledge that you gained from those life lessons. And certainly motherhood being here. Deepen that connection with your mother, with the mother figure in your life. And you know that even if your mother has ascended on, you have that relationship that you can just definitely connect with her on the other side. But deepen that spiritual connection with your partner, with yourself, with your mother or mother figure, grandmother, that maternal energy or matriarchal energy is your ancestor with ancient wisdom here. But that block, I feel, is blocking you in the way that you parent, whether you are a man or a woman, is really irrelevant. And whether you have children yet is really irrelevant. So you can absolutely change that energy around and create the healthiest energy and really break those chains of any toxic energy or blocks to creating the love that you really desire or renewing the type of connection in your committed partnership that you have now simply by deepening your spiritual connection with Source, just really praying and taking those action steps forward to face the fears of having that conversation, not necessarily being confrontational, but certainly not taking no for an answer. I feel like some of you are leaving a lot of discussions left to be said simply because someone's threatening to walk or and that sense of abandonment is real. You know, so that vibration is there. And remember that when you cast the first stone, that's what begins to expand the energy of change. You get that ripple effect. And your ancestors are going to be right there with that ripple effect, blessing you with the wisdom, helping you say what needs to be said. And release the fear of you either leaving, being told to leave, them leaving, or it not working out. If you're single, that fear of are they gonna leave me? Are they gonna even ascend on? Some people have had spouses and partners that have died, and they have that abandonment issue, and just not having it work out in any way, shape, or form. But knowing that that's affecting how you're parenting, whether you are again paternal or maternal, that nurturing energy is here. So how you are able to nurture your spouse, your partner, your significant other, your children even. But deepen that spiritual connection you have with Source within yourself. Meditate more, pray more, connect more on a spiritual level by deepening in the word of the Most High, whether that's through the Holy Bible, whether that is through the Kitabiathas, any kind of sacred spiritual text that is based on love and God. And look at you and your beautiful energy, my dear Capricorn Earth Angel. This is your affirmation here for the month. And you have 34, which is 7. And so the spiritual meaning to 34 is this new foundation has begun with the angels, the universe, the elements, the seasons. This is longevity on your side. And knowing that through this union of love, through this connection of love, it is divinely ordained and divinely timed. And so having to have that tough conversation creates that vibration of higher energy that nothing can separate, you know, nothing can take away. You can't break that. And so the fear doesn't have to be there of the abandonment. I am a guardian of Mother Earth and protect all who live on her. You know, I just feel also there's watch out for any unhealthy need of sense of responsibility. Watch out for that because I really feel like you have lived a serious need to be responsible based on what your life was like and is like. So just be careful that you do have a healthy attachment to your significant other and releasing that block there. Let me just stop right here before I ask for your animal spirit guide and just share with you where I feel your energy is blessed and the placement of the stars. I feel like Capricorn, you come into October with this fullness, this awareness that there's a release in your home life that needs to happen. There's a release in how you move about in your relationship life and the four, but behind the four walls inside of your home once you lock that door and you are separated from all of society. I feel like there is a closeness that you're seeking, and I feel like you know that it's definitely you're capable of having it, and I feel like you desire that, and I feel like you don't want to go anywhere. And so this right here, the leaving or travel, is really significant, and especially since that energy also governs motherhood and ancestral wisdom and spiritual connections. Allow that understanding that your spiritual guidance that comes to you in your messages, in your quietness, in your peace, while you're meditating, while you're just honoring the stillness, tell you what needs to stay in the past. Because on the 16th, give or take 72 hours before, certainly thereafter, you've got this blessed energy in your own energy. You're standing right under the stars of yourself. And this is a new beginning of who you are. And so you have this blessed time of starting a new path in longevity And being the one that says, we're going to have this conversation. We need to talk about retirement. We need to talk about inheritance. We need to talk about getting a will. We need to talk about getting married. We need to talk about, are we going to be together? What do we both want? I need to have conversations with God about the kind of spouse I want. If you're single, do I want to get married? We want to focus on with my love life. Those kind of conversations towards longevity and status. And it's a beautiful thing because at the end of the month, that energy says, where is true love for me? And am I with the love of my life or am I not? And if I am, we need to take that a step further now. And it's okay to do that. And the flirtation and the playfulness, is it there? Is it missing? And how can we get that back? So this is a beautiful month for you that says, I'm making some changes behind closed doors that we ain't gonna be telling everybody about. Oh goodness, for real. So there has been some deal breakers. Some of you are understanding that separation is real. The sense of abandonment is real. Thank you so much. Okay. Before I even show you these cards, remain vigilant. Stay strong. With the spirit of the walrus, remain vigilant about the current situation. Pay attention to signs and omens and let them dictate your choices. So there's a deal breaker here. You have been struggling with difficult information or you have recently found out information that made you react strongly. Spirit is urging you to get clear on what you want and need. What goes against your values goes against your self-worth. You may feel lonely temporarily, dear Capricorn, but Spirit is guiding you to keep your values and self-worth in your relationship life. There is a separation that is needed. It might have already happened. It is time to give each other some space. You have already separated or have it on your heart and soul. Pull back and honor your time with Spirit. Let your heart heal and be reminded of your connection with God. Bring your union or your relationship life to the Most High in prayer. So, dear Capricorn, this is a month of decision-making for you and honor your truth. Remember that your vibration is high and you deserve that relationship balance of high vibrational good energy in a partner and a spouse. You're highly connected to our ancestors and you don't have to go through life fearing the separation or whether or not it was the right thing to do or fearing that they're going to leave you or that you can't have the type of longevity, lifelong marriage or commitment or lifelong partnership that you so truly want. Trust the wisdom from your ancestors. Deepen your connection with Source. And I know that your spiritual guidance will lead you to your happiness. If there's anything that I can do for you, I'm here. Please click the links down below. I look forward to speaking with you soon, and I look forward to reading for you as well. Take great care, dear Capricorn. And remember, you deserve the type of love that's on your soul right now.